Alright, now we're going to take a look at a few settings that you want to take note before running your payroll process. That will be under Tools, Company Profile, and under this Contribution and Payout settings. So these are a few rules or contribution settings that you want to take note. This is because you might have something different. However, we are also set to the default government guidelines so that it will adhere to the government standards. If you have any changes you want to make, you can tick or untick, and there is a reset to default button if you want to change it back to the default settings. Next, under visibility, so this one is for you to show or hide the info that is in our payroll processor. So for companies, you might not have director fees, or maybe you do not need to have any Zakat or Tabung Haji payments. You can just untick this and it will not appear in your payroll processor. This is just a view or hide button. Next, we're going to go to our payroll setting. So this is used to calculate the number of unpaid leaves. How does the system calculate? So depending on your company, you might select one or the other. So it depends. You might have a fixed calculation day. Some companies fix it at maybe 26 days per month or based on your calendar. So you select whichever is applicable to you. Next is for the paid leave rates. So similar, you can select whichever is applicable to you. And finally, there is also a rounding feature. So you can round up to the nearest 5, 10, 50 or ringgit. Alright, finally, there is a reports feature. So finally, after you process your payroll, the system will have a quick access or shortcuts to the reports available after payroll processing. By default, everything is selected. So if you want to reduce the amount of reports shown after processing your payroll, you can untick this. However, the reports will still be generated and available under report section. So this is just a quick access after processing your payroll. And remember, after changing anything, click the save button on the top right corner.